A very special episode of Easy Buckets. Today we're gonna be talking about 5 sleeper picks in fantasy basketball. Woo! So guys, basically in this list there are 5 players who are ranked less than 100, guys. So basically these players are known as sleeper picks, or players that you don't usually think about getting in the early rounds. What I'm saying is that these players you will be able to get in the later rounds and will give you top 100 value by the end of the season. I 100% believe that all these 5 players are going to be great fantasy players and should be in the top 8 of your fantasy squads. In other words, these players should not be lower than the 8th rounds of your fantasy squad. So without further ado, let's go straight to this list. The first player on this list is Chris Dunn of the Chicago Bulls.
I personally do not believe why Chris Dunn is less than the 100 ranking, guys. Chris Dunn had an amazing season last year, averaging 13.4 points, 4.3 rebounds, 6.0 assists, and 2.0 steals, guys. But the question that I'm asking is, why is Chris Dunn not valid to be one of the best point guards at an upcoming value basis? I believe that this year, the Chicago Bulls have many players that will break out into amazing fantasy basketball season. I believe Chris Dunn is that playmaker of the team, guys. He is that starting point guard. And I believe this year, Chris Dunn will be running the offense under Fred Hoiberg and averaging over plus 15 points, plus 6 assists, and plus 2 steals, guys. Chris Dunn is a defensive monster on the fantasy end and could be giving you a triple-double on a nightly basis. Yes, guys, I do believe Chris Dunn has that potential, guys. It is because he is the future of the franchise. Because at the end of the day, you will not trade Jimmy Butler for not a player for the future of the franchise.
The second player on this list is Caris LeVert of the Brooklyn Nets.
Caris LeVert of the Brooklyn Nets, guys, because Jeremy Lin is out of the picture, guys. Last year, Caris LeVert had an amazing season, especially ending off the season, guys. He was getting starter minutes, and Brooklyn really seems to love Caris LeVert playing that 3-2-1 spot. He is very versatile in positioning, guys, and is long enough to play 3 positions in the NBA. Last year, he averaged 12.1 points, 3.7 rebounds, and 4.2 assists with 1.2 steals, guys. And I believe this year, with Jeremy Lin gone, he's going to be more of the focal point and more of the development for the Brooklyn Nets, guys. So draft Caris LeVert in the 9th or 10th rounds, because he would definitely be a great pickup then.
The third player is DeJounte Murray of the San Antonio Spurs.
DeJounte Murray is now the spotlight of the San Antonio Spurs, guys. Besides DeRozan and besides Aldridge, DeJounte Murray is the third player on that squad, guys, especially with Manu Ginobili retiring and Tony Parker being signed somewhere else in Charlotte Hornets. DeJounte Murray is the point guard, the playmaker, and the player of the team that they will develop to be their future franchise point guard. DeJounte Murray's specialty is that he is a defensive player, guys. On a nightly basis, he'll give you a double-double with 10 points and 10 rebounds, guys. But I believe this year, his points will rack up and his defensive rating will definitely increase as well. Last year, he only played limited minutes, and when he did play, he put up great numbers, guys. But last year, he averaged 8.1 points, 5.7 rebounds, 2.9 assists, and 1.2 steals, guys. And that's really good for a player not playing more than 25 minutes a game. But when he did get those minutes, he was the guy to go to in San Antonio Spurs. So draft DeJounte Murray, guys. I believe he should be the third or fourth point guard of your squads.
The fourth player on this list is De'Aaron Fox of the Sacramento Kings.
De'Aaron Fox of the Sacramento Kings, guys, is one of the players I believe will break out into amazing point guard in the NBA, guys. We all know he is fast. We all know he is able to pick up the ball. We all know he can dribble. And he reminds us of a younger John Wall. Last year, he didn't start every game for the Sacramento Kings, guys, but when he did great and averaged over 15 points, guys. But overall, he averaged 11.6 points, 2.8 rebounds, 4.4 assists, and 1.0 steals, guys. And I believe this year, with everybody leaving, guys, with George Hill leaving, I believe De'Aaron Fox is going to be that future franchise point guard and could be the best third point guard on your team, giving you top 100 value 100%.
And the fifth and final player of this list, guys, is Alex Len, now of the Atlanta Hawks.
Alex Len is probably the best sleeper in this draft, guys, because he's ranked 253rd in the pre-rankings in fantasy basketball. Last year, he averaged 8.5 points, 7.5 rebounds, and 1.1 blocks per game, guys. But I believe this year, him being traded to the Atlanta Hawks, guys, he is going to be that focal point center, guys. And because the playing styles of Alex Len being a back-to-basket player and Trae Young do match, I believe that future in Atlanta Hawks could definitely be good for Alex Len. Alex Len is your guy, guys. So pick Alex Len in the 12th round because he will be slept on. And mark my words, he will be a decent fantasy player, averaging 10 points and nearly 10 rebounds a game.
and hope you guys really enjoyed that video, guys. That list was actually not that easy to come up with because there are many players under the 100 rank that should be valued and to be looked at. There are way more players and way more sleepers out there, guys, so I'm going to be making more sleeper pick videos, so stay tuned for that. And if you guys are new to Easy Buckets, guys, join the Easy Gang by clicking that subscribe button. And also, if you love the video and the list, give me a thumbs up as well. And let me know down in the comment section down below which players that I miss or which players that you agree on. And alright, guys, I got a contest alert, guys. So basically, guys, I'm gonna be hosting an NBA 2K19 giveaway, guys. So if you are interested in the picture, it's gonna be right here, guys. So basically what it is if you wanna be a part of this contest, guys, all you gotta do is go to my Instagram at easy.buckets. Follow that account. I'm trying to make easy.buckets on Instagram my one-on-one connection with you guys. And also put an emoji down there so I know that you guys really want to be a part of this contest. And of course, subscribe, because who wouldn't want to be a part of the Easy Gang? Other than that, guys, take it easy. God bless. And I'll see you next time on Easy Buckets. Woo! Yeah. Friends of the family. Do it for the friends of the family. Friends of the family. Do it for the friends of the family. Who else? Friends of the family. Do it for the friends of the family. Friends of the family. You don't know them, you don't know me, man.